Good evening, good morning, good afternoon, and greetings to one and all present here. I am Sridevi Srinivasan, President of Dynamic Leaders Forum Toastmasters Club. Our club is in District 120, Division H, Area 2. We meet every Sunday from 2:30 p.m. to 4 p.m. for our club meetings. To know more about our club, please visit the link that appears in the chat window. We have started a workshop series for sharing our knowledge, as we always believe that sharing our knowledge multiplies not only our knowledge, it also multiplies, expands our network and paves way for exponential growth. And in this testing pandemic times, we want to utilize the best out of the opportunities that we have in front of us. And the result is the knowledge sharing series. Last week, we had the knowledge sharing series of branding using PowerPoint presentation. And this weekend, we are having yet another series, yet another workshop on creating videos using Canva. To present this workshop, we have our dynamic Toastmaster. She is our past president, immediate past president. She is my mentor. She was a principal in a school, and she is a successful entrepreneur. Now I invite Toastmaster Dr. Ashwati Rajan to start this workshop. Thank you.
A very warm good evening, good morning to all the fellow Toastmasters and dear guests who have joined from all around the world. Thank you so much for joining us today. So as our president, Toastmaster Sridevi Srinivasan, just told that this is a part of knowledge sharing series, which is an initiative of Dynamic Leaders Forum Toastmasters Club. And the first part of the series was a workshop which was exclusively done for PowerPoint presentations by Toastmaster Cyril. And this is the second part of the same series, branding workshop using Canva, where I'll be touching upon a little about branding and more about poster and flyer preparation using Canva and video preparation using Canva. So before I get into the business, these are some ground rules which you all can follow. And also, we have a link which is shared in the chat box. You all can see that. For the Mentimeter, you all can go through it, click on the link, and please share your expectations from today's workshop. We would like to hear from all of you. You can even scan from the screen. It is also there. Thank you so much. Zoom Master, can you just share the results? Can you show some reactions? Great, great, great. Thank you so much for this overwhelming response. Wow, great. Thank you so much. Thank you, Zoom Master. So now, coming back to the session. So today's session, I have broadly divided into three parts. The first one will be about branding guidelines. So I know there are some non-Toastmasters also in the workshop. So please excuse for a few minutes because I'll be just touching upon this topic as we have already taken in detail in our previous session, which you all can go and see. It is available on our YouTube channel. And I request Zoom Master to please share the link also of the previous workshop so that you can go to our YouTube channel and see that workshop and see the brand guidelines, which is explained in detail. So now, about the branding, as you know, that it is the essence of the PR work which we do in Toastmasters. It is the essence of Toastmasters. So first and foremost thing which all the VPPRs or all the people who are working on any promotional material to do is to download brand manual and go through it. So how to do it for the new VPPRs or the new members, for their benefit, I'm just telling you the route to find out a brand manual. Just log into the Toastmasters website, go to resources and open brand portal, and there you'll find the brand manual, which is the new version is uploaded there. You can download the PDF file of this brand manual and go through it. So that is your first step. So now I'll be just taking an overview of the main elements which we'll be doing or using in our Canva, creating PR material through Canva. So the first important part of this branding is colors, the color palette. So as you all know, the Toastmasters who are there, experienced Toastmasters, they all know that we have limited colors. And there are three basic, the primary colors which are given in Toastmasters International. And here you can see in the screen, the true maroon, loyal blue and cool gray. So because we will be working today on Canva, so these are the hex code which is given below. Hex code is a unique code for this particular color. Then we have an accent color, which is yellow, happy yellow. And this is the hex code for happy yellow. And primary colors we can use anywhere in the background, in a shape, anywhere you can use in a font. But accent color is little particular because we don't keep it in a background or we don't use much of this color. This color is mainly to highlight the points which you need to highlight in your flyer. For example, your club's name, the keynote speaker's name, the date of the meeting, theme of the meeting. Such important things which need to be highlighted, we put it in blue, yellow color. And other two colors are black and white, which are like colors by default, so you can use it anywhere. And then we have this beautiful elements which is now added in our brand manual. It is gradient. In last workshop, it was explained, Toastmaster Cyril explained in detail. So I will not go into much of this detail, but still, these are the different types of gradients, different effects of these primary colors, which we have, the blue, maroon, and cool gray. You can have different types of gradients, you can see here. And the new color code, the code, hex code is also given. So the one, loyal blue is the normal primary color. And the other code is of a different blue, which is a blissful blue here. So we have different types of gradients with blue. These are with two different colors. And here you can see there are three shades. In the middle, there is a different shade. And on both sides, again, we have loyal blue. So this is like three-step gradient. Then same way, we also have it for maroon and cool gray. So this is something new which is added, and we can really do some great stuff using this gradient, which we'll be doing it today. Then another feature which is added in our brand manual is transparency. Again, a very interesting feature which you can explore differently. And there are three different versions which is given to all are using the primary colors. You can see here. And the blue and maroon are having a white on the top, and this white color is made 70% transparent, because of which you can see this effect. So beyond 70, if you pull it down, the color will change completely. So that is the reason it is not allowed here. So we keep it up to 70% alone. But in case of cool gray, we don't use it white over the over it because it is a very light color. So on the top or over this gray, cool gray, we normally use blue. So that is the difference here. So these three kind of transparencies you can use while creating your posters or even in videos. So now coming to the fonts. Fonts, basically we have two major fonts in our brand manual. First is Gotham and second is Myriad Pro. And these are the fonts which are available in PowerPoint. But today we are talking all about Canva. So we have an alternate here. We have Montserrat, which is available in the free version of Canva. So you can use Montserrat here. And for an alternate for Myriad Pro is Source Sans Pro. So this is the other font which you can use. So other than these fonts, we are not supposed to use. And these are the Mac fonts which are having almost same type of fonts like Gotham and Myriad Pro. So this was about the fonts. And the next element which is very, very important for creating any PR material is logo. So you can see here, if you go to toastmasters.org/logos, we can see all these types of logos there. So the first is our basic, the main logo of Toastmasters International. You have three varieties there. You have in a grayscale, you have a white logo, and this one is the colored logo. You can use any of them. And always it is better to use the PNG version of this logo. Then we have this logo lockups. Then we also have pathway logos. This kind of pathway logo also comes in different color versions. Then pathways badges, which you can see here. These pathways badges, they come for all the 11 paths. So all these badges you can use for some peculiar flyer or your video where you have to congratulate a member who has completed one level or even a path. Then you can use these kind of badges there. So according to your need, you can use this logo. The rule which you need to remember while using this logo is a free breathing space around the logo, which the rule applies to the normal logo, logo wordmark also. There should be an equal free space, a breathing space around the logo. Any object nearby logo should not touch or should not be placed too close to the logo. And wherever you are placing, the logo should be distinct. It should be prominent. It should be visible clearly. So these are few points which you need to remember while creating any flyer. So I request all of you to go through the brand manual and read all these things detail. I have just taken few elements which are very important. So next we have images and photography. So these are a very important part of any flyer or video which we create. So there are again some restrictions when it comes to images and photographs. In brand manual, it is clearly mentioned that you cannot use cartoons, you cannot use illustrations, you cannot use a picture of nature, buildings, architecture, food, appliances, animals, children. So all these things are restricted. So you cannot use all these pictures. So now which kind of picture you can use? So these are some examples which I have taken from the resources available in Toastmasters International website. In brand portal, we have professional images. You can go to that and then download the professional images which are present there. Other than this, you are free to use images from your club meeting, from a seminar hall, from a conference hall, where people are engaged in and they are showing some leadership or engaging activities, public speaking, mentoring. So all these things which are related to Toastmasters International, and that those kind of images only are permitted and can be used. So other than that, definitely there's a big no for that. You cannot use the other images. So this is the place where you can get the images in Toastmasters website. And there are also some free online, you can download like free pick and all. You can see that also if there is no copyright issue and the pictures, they match the requirement, then definitely you can. Okay, so let me stop here. And if you have anything related to this part, the branding, you can put your queries in the chat box. I'll be happy to answer. And then we'll quickly move on to Canva. Yes, so Rohit Pandey is asking, can we use club members pick in case he or she is a TMOD? Definitely, yes. You can use your club members picture, an engaging picture where it is depicting the essence of Toastmasters. Definitely, you can use this. Why it is recommended to use PNG versus JPEG image? Because you can see that there is a white background which appears in a JPG image, so which looks sometimes very odd when you place it on a flyer, whereas PNG image, it is very clear without a background. So preferably if you use that will be really nice. No, you cannot use emoji. As I said, the emojis, cartoons, illustrations, you cannot use those. Okay, again, those pictures, we cannot use angels and theme in like depending on your, but you can think other ways. See, when we are into a creative thing, definitely we can think differently and somehow we can connect to it, to our meetings or to the professional pictures which we have. So it is better to go with that rather than these kind of pictures. And can we use white background or just the primary colors? Yes, you can use primary colors. Primary colors, all maroon, blue or cool gray, you can have it as a background. Yes, you can use if your club is organizing an outdoor meeting, an outdoor activity, and you are having your club members in the picture, definitely you can use that picture where your club members are engaged in some activity. Definitely you can use those kind of pictures. Then can we use a picture where the element of theme of the day is present with the confident? Empowered person being the main element of the picture. Yes, you can. Yes, you can use. You can use. The basic thing is it should depict something which is relating to the Toastmasters International.
Ma'am, I registered for my son only. He's a Gavalier. But I have a question. If we want to use the picture of a ship or some object like that, I heard that in an earlier training that actually a Toastmaster should be standing on the ship, then we can use it. Or maybe Toastmaster posing against a ship, we can use it. Otherwise, yes, we are not permitted to use a ship or any other common objects, right?
Yes, yes, that is true. We can have a Toastmaster or your TMOD standing in front of that background or maybe standing in a nature. So that way you can use the picture, but not a picture of a nature or any object like that. You cannot use.
So just as it was mentioned now, so in case, so does that person has to be professionally dressed near a ship or let's, or suppose if the theme is pets, so if a happy, confident person is holding a pet, so will that do? Since they mentioned that the people in the picture should appear happy, empowered and confident.
Yes, 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 you can. But picture of the pet alone, you cannot.
Okay. Yeah.
And someone is asking, can we use Canva available pictures related meeting theme? Yes, you can. There are free pictures which are available in Canva. So you can use those pictures also. Okay, I think... now we can start with Canva. Okay. just give me a second.
I mean, the same goes true for any food items, etc. also, right? Anything that we use, suppose the theme is about food, we should have a Toastmaster pose with that food item. Am I right, ma'am? Just confirming.
Yes.
Common doubt, that's right.
Yes, yes. Yes, you are correct. So this is Canva. So Canva, when it comes to poster creating posters, flyers or videos, it is a very easy to use tool. And the best part is it is free. The free version, it offers lot of elements, lot of features which you can explore and create beautiful PR material. So we are now going to Canva. You can log into Canva. You can log in through your Gmail or Facebook account and create your Canva account. So here, once we open, you can choose a template. It depends on your requirement, if it is for an Instagram post or a Facebook post. So Canva offers many such varieties of templates. You can see here the presentation template, poster, Instagram post. So depending on your requirement, you can just choose any kind of template from here. So I am going to select an Instagram post. So when you open or when you select any such template, Canva will also offer you many designs which are there, present, the free designs. So you can use such designs and convert into the brand complaint thing if you want that way, you can do. But if you want to start from the scratch, so I suggest to have an open a blank template. So we'll start from the scratch. We will have a blank slide, a blank template where we are going to create our flyer. So the first thing which you need is a background. You can keep it white. There is no such issue here. You can make the you can keep the background white and put other colored elements over it. But you can also try different backgrounds. So the basic kind of background which you can have is using the primary colors. So you can just click on the slide. You can see here on the top background color. You can click there and you can choose the here I have made a brand kit with these three colors. So you can click on any of the color. It depends on your choice. You can have maroon or you can have blue. So you can choose any color. Another option is to have a gradient in the background. So for that, how to create a gradient background? Go to elements. Type gradient here. And you can see here there are different gradients which are there in Canva. So you need to choose a gradient with two colors. So let's see, where is it? Yes. So this one here, when you click on this, you can see here on the top, it has two different colors. Hello, can you see?
Yes, we can.
Yes.
Yes.
Thank you. So here we will be creating now a gradient with this. So here for creating a gradient, we have two colors because there are two colors in this picture. We have the first code is the normal blue, the loyal blue. So we'll click on the picture and then here on the color and select the normal blue. So this part will change into that normal blue. Then we can see the next code, which is 006094. Here, you click on the second color and type here 006094. So this is the second color. That color will appear when you put the hex code on the top. Click on it, and here your gradient is ready. So if you remember in the brand manual, we have different directions, different orientations of this gradient box. So you can rotate it. If you want from left to right, keep it like this. If you want from top to bottom, you can just rotate this top to bottom, or from left to right, or from bottom to top. It's up to you. You can just rotate it and place it the way you want. So here, so we are keeping it from top to bottom. Then you can just stretch it and make it fit in this template. Same way you can create it for the maroon color or the cool gray. For three color gradient, again go to elements, go to gradients, and here you have to choose a gradient shape with three different colors. Yes, so this one is having three different colors. So here you can put the color code for the three colors. So we can do it for maroon. So one code is 3B0104. It is, click on this 3B0104. Yes, so click here again on the the next corner, same color, and in the middle you have a different color, which is 781327. Sorry. Okay. Yes. So now this is for three color gradient. So where on both the sides you have same color, and in the middle you have different color. So you can have this kind of gradient also, where you have three colors, or you can use the white, the one with white. So this is how you can use gradient. Then other options are, there are circles, you can just explore it. There are different shapes, circles with two colors. You can even use those circles with two color gradient. You just need to remember the codes, or just see the manual, put in the codes and prepare your gradient. This was about gradients. Then let's start creating our flyer. Now the background is ready. Now one thing which we need to remember is, now this is a shape. So when we move anything which we place over this slide, this background also will move. So it will be which will be disturbing us while creating the flyer, because when we work, so you need to lock it. Just click on it.
Hello.
And here you can see on the right corner, lock. So when you click on this, your slide will be locked, your background will be locked. So this you can do it with any kind of background or any picture. If we are placing it on the template and you lock it, it will not move from there. It will just lock. Let's try it with an image. Zoom master, can you mute the
participants?
I request all the participants to please stay on mute. Okay, let's try it with an image. So if we place an image here, we can even lock this image. You click on the image. Sorry, if you want to have this image as a background, you can keep this image in the background and also you can lock it. Another thing, now coming to the text. So you can click here on the text. You can see here, add a heading, add a subheading or a title. So you can choose a heading. Let's give a heading. You know that we can't use any font. We need Montserrat as a heading for the heading. So you can click here. You can see Montserrat have different versions. You can have any of it. I am going with this Montserrat semi bold. So you can have that font. You can use this and make a heading. Now there are other options which you can try. You can give some effects to it. Click on the effects. You can make it look a little brighter by lifting the fonts. So in some colors, it really looks very good with black on white, yellow on dark colors. This effect really comes out well, so you can use. And some other options are also there, but make sure that when you put or when you use such effects, the color of the font or it should not look very different from your Toastmasters color. So that's the only thing which you need to remember here. So we have placed the text. You can see here other options. We have the option of animating any text which you can use while creating a video. You can position the text. If you click on the position, you can place it on the top, on in middle, or left, right, wherever you want. You can just place your text. So then again, then this is another option, copy style. So if you click on this, this will copy the color. If it is a text, then it will copy the color of the font. Sorry. If you have any object here, it will make it white because color of the the letters are white. So that way it will, because now we have locked the screen, it will not change. The lock the background, it is not changing. But you can click here, click on the object or on the text which you have written, and then click outside the background or outside the text, then the whole thing will become white. If it is a picture, you click on the picture, click outside, the whole background will become that picture. So that is a different feature. Then we have transparency, which we'll use, we'll see. And then we have this option for linking. You can create link anything here, you have a link to be added here. You can just enter that. But remember, that will only be used, or that can be used only when you are using a PDF version. When you are taking a PDF version of the document or the material which you are creating, then only that link will work. It will not work on JPG. For example, if you want to create a newsletter, in newsletter you want to embed a link, or maybe your website link, your club's website, your YouTube channel's link, social media handles. If you want to embed there, you can just click on the text or on the shape also. If there are some symbols given, a symbol of YouTube channel or Facebook, you can click on that object and then enter the link there and apply. If you apply, and then if you create the PDF of that document, in the PDF that link will be available. If you click on that object, it will direct you to the website or the given link. So that is one very nice feature which can be used in newsletters or any such documents. So these are the few features which are available here and you can use. This is for copying, just you can create a duplicate. This is again for locking. If you click here, it will lock the object. It will not move from here. But right now we don't want to lock the object because we may move it here. So now let's add an image here. So these are some of the images which I have got from the Toastmasters website. So let's use this image. So image you can use directly like this. You can just place wherever you want. You can just move your cursor and it will revolve anywhere. Another option to use a image is using a frame. So I'll show you how to use a frame. Just go to Elements. Use Frames. And it will show you different options for these frames. So you can choose any of the frames. Let us go with this one. So we have this frame now. So you can use any picture. You can put a picture inside it. Maybe a different picture. You can just click and drag and leave. So that's very easy because the picture is not fitting here because the orientation is different. But you can use any picture of your clubmates or the guests, anyone you can add in this frame. So there are different types of frames available here in Elements. You can use accordingly. You can even change the border of the frame. There are some options with two different types of frames. You can see here the frame with two pictures. So in such frames, you can have two different type of pictures here like this. So in both the frames, you can put picture together, different pictures together. So you can just explore different types of frames which are available here in Canva. So without frame, it will look like this. You can have this like this also. Then coming to the shapes, if you want to have some different types of shapes here, then go to shapes. In Elements, go to shapes. There different shapes are available. You can use any shape. Now let me take square. So this is, you can change the shape. You can make it thin. You can make it small. So it's all up to you. You can. So you can change the color of the shape. Again, click on the shape. You can go to change color. You can give any color you want. if you want to apply transparency here, again, because in the manual you saw that transparency is applied when there is a white object on the top of the darker element. So here it is maroon and the background is blue, so we cannot apply that feature here. So better, if you need, better to change it into white. Let's do that. Try transparency. Now this is white. Now let us make it transparent. On the top right, you can see the option for transparency. Click here. Make it 70%. So this, it will appear like this. So beyond that, that effect will look very different. It will be, it will change the color. So it is not advisable. So you can use for the, someone has put a question in the chat box that what color we can use for the text. So there is no such restriction. You can put any color means the brand colors. You can use maroon, blue, black, white, yellow, cool gray, but it should be in contrast with the background. It should clearly, it should project the text which you are putting in the text. For example, here in the flyer, the background is blue. So it is always recommended to use the lighter colors, white and cool gray, or even yellow. Yellow will also look bright. So you can use that too. If the background is light, for example, white or cool gray, better to go with the darker shades, maroon, blue, black for the text. Is there any branding available for frames and shapes? No, we don't have any such restrictions. You can use any type of frames which are available here. So this is about the transparency effect. So if it is, the background is gray, if you remember I showed in the beginning, if the background is gray, cool gray, then over it you need to place an object with blue and make it transparent. If you are using the transparency feature here. So for cool gray, it is different. It should be blue. Black color cannot be used for the background. If you see in Toastmasters manual also, it is there, all the objects or even the logo, if you see, there is no black. They kind of, they don't use much of this black color except in font or maybe in small objects you can use, but not in background. So yellow and black, they are not used in for the background. Yes, in Canva, but many features are free which you can explore and create flyers. There are many new features which are added. For example, the animation, the curve effect, you can see here, the effects in effects. If you go, there is a curve shaped option. If you click, your text will appear like this. So all these are some new features or updated version of free Canva. This is the free version of Canva. So you have many options which you can use and create such PR materials. So only few restrictions, but definitely free option, it offers you a lot. So this is about the picture and the transparency. Sometimes we can even make the picture transparent, and that too always restrict it up to 70% as it so that the picture should not lose its the brightness or much effect. That effect should not be lost, so you can keep it that way also. Yes, so here now, this is the basic thing which, these are the basic features which you can use to create a flyer. You can use any type of object. You can see here many different types of objects are there which you can place on your flyer. You can change colors. You can add different types of frames, different pictures inside the frame. You can give a border to the picture. For example, like this, if you click on that shape, you can even place a border around your picture. So you can try different things. there are some shapes with border already, they have a border, so you can click on that shape, you can select that shape, and always you can add a picture inside it. But this is the other option I'm showing, where you can have a margin or border around your picture. So now if you want to create a video in Canva, a simple basic Canva video, how to do it? So as I said, there are some options like animation which you can use for while doing a video. You can also upload a video which is already there. I'll show you how to do it. I'll add a frame. So this is a frame. These are the frames which are available. So let me add this frame. So now this is a frame. So I'm placing a frame here. Another thing which I wanted to show was the placement of logo. So logo, this is the PNG version which I have downloaded and uploaded in Canva. You can just take that logo and adjust the size. So I am just making it smaller. So always remember, if you want to adjust the size of the logo, don't stretch it from the sides. If you stretch it, it will cut the logo from any side. It is not advisable to stretch, pull it. You can just drag from the corners to adjust the size, and then you can place it anywhere you want. And always remember, the space around the logo should be equal. There should be an equal breathing space around the logo, and it should not touch a text or an object which is there on the flyer. Another important feature which is there is now you can place the logo on a background with the picture. So if there is a background picture here in the flyer, still you can use the logo, but you need to make sure that the logo is prominent, it is distinctively visible, it is clearly visible and not getting merged inside the picture. So that's the thing which you need to take care. So now I was talking about the video. If you are creating a video and you have a video from your club member, you can just upload there in Canva. I have few videos here, so let me see. Okay. So I have just clicked, dragged and added this video, which is already a video created by me. So it is added inside this frame. So likewise, you can create a video from your club members, a TMOD inviting for the meeting or describing the theme or something about your keynote speaker. Any such videos can be created and added. You can add inside the frame like this. Any kind of frame can be used. See, this frame is having a border, so you can even change the color of the border here. Let me make it white because now it is prominent. So like this, you can add a video. yes, you can. Someone is asking whether we can use white color. Yes, ma'am. Video link can be used. Video link you cannot use here, sir. You need to add the video directly. You need to add the video, upload the video in Canva, and then drag it or click on it and add the video inside the frame. That's how you need to add the video. Link you can provide in any document which you are downloading as a PDF. As I showed you, if there is a text, if you are mentioning a text and you want to embed a link or a video link with that, you can very well do. You just click on it and go to this option, and here you can link it. Link, put the link of the video which you want to embed there and apply it. That's the option. But Finally, what you need to do is you have to download the document as PDF. From here, you can download the final copy. So you need to select here and you need to download it as PDF. Then only your embedded link will work. It will not work in videos or flyers. So here I have added a video. You can also animate something, the text, the pictures. So here, let me add. I have added the text. Let me change the font. So this is a text which I want to animate. Click on that. You can see this option, animate. Click on it. There are some free options which are there. You can see here. There are many such options. You can just click. This is like a block effect. You can see the typewriter option. This is something new which is added in Canva, and it works very well with the videos. When you have many pages there, you can have use this feature sharing. You can see this text like a typewriter effect. Then these are other options, bounce. These are few new options which are there added recently in Canva. So in free versions also, you can see a lot of things which you can use to create really beautiful, interesting videos. So these are some of the animations which are available for the text. For the picture also, you can use animations. Click on the picture. You can see these are the options which are available for a picture. You can see here, you can click on this. Another thing which you can do here with the video which you have uploaded here, click on the video and you think that this video is too long. And there is some error. Finally, there is an error at the end of the video or in the beginning of the video. You want to change the length of the video. Then that option is also available here. Click on the video. You can see here on the top, there is a scissor, a small icon here. Click on this. Then you can drag it. You can make it short. You can make the video short from behind or from the beginning also. So that way, click on done. You can cut the video short. You can make it short. Another option is to reduce the volume. Click on this. You can see here the volume icon is there. Now it is 100%. You can click here and reduce it. So these are some other options which you can use while creating the video on Canva. So let me see the questions on chat. Yes, someone is asking, can we apply effects to the font? Yes, we can, but you only thing which you need to take care is it should not deviate from the color palette, the usual color palette which is suggested. It should not look very different. If it is maroon, it should appear maroon. If you are applying some different types of effects, it may look different. So that is the only point here. Then animate is also applicable to the video. Yes, we can. Here, if you see, I have just applied animation to the video also. It can be applied. Any other questions? Okay. Yes, I'll just show how to download and play the video. flyers, you can save it in JPG, in PNG, you can save. If you need PDF also, it is okay. You can save it as PDF. But mainly the newsletter or such kind of material only we download as PDF, where you are embedding the links and all, so it will be convenient for you. Otherwise, the flyers, you can do it as JPG or PNG images. Have to be proportionate, as in, can the flyer have more of yellow and very less of blue and maroon? See, the yellow is called as accent color, which is only used for highlighting the points which you need to highlight in the flyer. So more of yellow is not recommended, and you can use it in only at special areas where it is needed, as I said, as in the name of your club or the name of the speaker. For such things, you can add. Yeah, you can, sir. Max, how to increase the size of the video? Yes, you can. You can just pull it. You can even keep the video in the back, the whole background. Let me show you that also. I'm adding a new slide here. And yes, italics is also allowed. You can use. I am... So you can just, sorry, you can just, so you can just drag the video and place it here in the as a background. So you can have it as a background. So the whole slide, a whole template will be covered with the video. So that way, if you want to use like this, you can do it this way also, or if you want to put it in a frame, you can use any kind of frame and add a picture or a video inside that. So let me show you how to download it. You can just click on download. So this is a video, better to go with this MP4 videos, download it, and then it will be saved in wherever you want. You can save it and then play it, send it through WhatsApp or mail, wherever you want, you can use it. The is Arial font allowed? Sir, the recommended font, which is an alternate to Myriad Pro, is Source Sans Pro. So that's what is recommended by Toastmasters International. So we go with that. It is available in free version of Canva also. So you can use that font. Yes, we can place a text over a transparent object also. So the video is getting downloaded. Let's wait for that. So the session is open for any questions. If you have any other doubts also, you can ask your doubts or even put it in the chat box. And also, it would be nice if you all can switch on your cameras. We would like to capture this session with this moment with all of you. And I hope you enjoyed today's session. Your questions are still welcome. You can put your questions in the chat box by the time the video is getting downloaded. And now I hand it over to the president of Dynamic Leaders Forum Toastmasters Club, Toastmaster Sridevi, by the time you all can type your questions also. Thank you all. Over to you, Sridevi.
Thank you, Toastmaster Dr. Ashwati Rajan. That was a wonderful session, enlightening one. And I hope all of you had a wonderful time, nice learning experience. And I would like to ask you if you can switch on your camera and we can have a photograph, group photograph. Thank you. Let me just doing it screen by screen. So please hold on. Thank you so much. But I also like to request each and every one of you to share your feedback. The feedback, you can share it in the link that is provided in the chat window. Just sharing it.
By the time, I will also show the video which we just created. Just a second.
A leader leads by example. A leader inspires. A leader motivates. A leader facilitates. A leader guides.
So this is how the final video will come. So you can create many such wonderful videos using all these options which are available in Canva, which is exclusively free. So that is something really nice. You can really explore different features in Canva and create flyers and videos.
Thank you, Toastmaster Dr. Ashwin. And thank you, each and every one of you. I request you to kindly give your feedback in the link that is provided. I just shared the link. I think you started pouring in the comments in the chat window itself. So I'm just sharing the link again. We'll be sharing these videos, we'll be publishing these videos in the YouTube channel and we'll share those links to your email as well. Hope to see you all in another sharing series, knowledge sharing series. I wish you all the best and stay safe and happy to speak straight.
Thank you, Ashwati.
Welcome.
Ma'am, we have a few questions here.
Yes, definitely. This sorry, I missed to say that definitely this is available on as an app also. You can open it in your mobile and you can work. In fact, many of my flyers which I do will be while traveling on my mobile. So it is very convenient. You can use a mobile app and create flyers or whatever you want on mobile also. It is the same. Thank you all for this overwhelming reactions. Thank you. Yes, for Christmas, there is a question that for Christmas, what can we use? Sorry, I missed the question. What can we use as the background? Definitely, if it is a brand complaint, if you need a brand complaint poster, it should be with these colors, with these primary colors. Maybe you can use a maroon background. You can have pictures of your members with Christmas cap, the, you know, all those things you can have. You can think innovatively, you can think differently, and to stay brand compliant, you need to follow the guidelines.
Can I ask a question to Toastmaster Aswati?
Yes.
Hi. In the beginning, when we see there are different tabs like presentation or office or marketing purpose, and then in that there are different options again, categories, posters and flyers. So what's the basic difference of that?
There are different versions, like if you want to use it for the Instagram, there will be an Instagram template which will fit correctly in Instagram. Same way for Facebook, it will be different. For Zoom background, the correct size will be available, the template will be available. So based on the sizes, these templates, they vary. And of course, there are some templates which are specially designed for videos, which you can, if you select those templates, it will correctly fit on any mobile screen. So it is basically the size of the template, the different sizes. So based on your requirement, you can choose any template.
Yeah, I understand. Size and maybe the pixels quality as well.
Yes, right? yes.
So generally for our flyers, we would be using the poster?
Yes, you can use posters. There are flyer, one template called flyer is also available. Then the Instagram, which I used, Facebook post, anything you can use.
Okay. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
I have one doubt.
Yes.
Can we use any kind of picture from Canva, or should be related only to Toastmasters?
It should be engaging. It should connect to Toastmasters. That's the only point. You can use pictures from Canva also. It should connect to Toastmasters, engaging pictures, which may reflect the essence of Toastmastering, public speaking, people in a meeting, an office setup, all such pictures you can use.
But it depends on the theme also, right? The TMOD is, you know, what theme?
Yeah, you can match it with your theme, definitely, but also in the same in the same time, it should reflect the branding element of Toastmasters. It should not go away from, like, if theme is cartoon, you cannot use cartoons there. Okay. Maybe a TMOD wearing a t-shirt with cartoon picture, that may work better, I think. So that way you need to think differently and use. It should, and you should stick to the branding. That's the only point.
Okay. Thank you.
Good evening. I have a question. Now, this workshop we came to know through our district 116. And that's how, like, the first workshop that you conducted, we didn't know. Now that we have registered for this workshop, whenever you're conducting another workshop or a training program, how do we come to know? Because I would definitely like to participate.
Definitely.
I've got to learn things today, and I'm really happy for that. I would like to be a part of many more training programs like this.
Sure. Whenever we conduct such events, we definitely try to project and share it in the social media or the other sites. But it will be nice if you can connect with our club. Yeah, you can see the link here in the chat box. You can connect, and you can you will be updated with the upcoming events.
Okay, thank you very much.
We have the guest group link also, WhatsApp guest group link also in this link that I have posted here. So you can join our guest group, wherein we will share all these details.
Thank you.
Excuse me. Hi, I'm from District 82. Thank you so much for conducting this type of wonderful presentation. We all amazed, I believe. My question is, when you are reducing that logo, there is a way that we can reduce, we can't reduce too much, or like that is the hard and fast rule?
You can go through the brand manual. There is a size limit which is given there. So beyond that, if we stretch our logo or make it smaller, definitely the features will not be visible. It will get distorted. So you have to stick to that limit. Let me share that brand manual here and show you. Just a minute, I'll show in the brand manual.
And the next question is, when we are using photos of club meeting, does that banner with the name of the club and or the badges that we are wearing, do those needs to be inside in the picture? I mean, those needs to be reflected in the picture. Other than that, is there a way that identifying this is a club meeting, or how does that apply?
I didn't get your question.
No, I'm asking, when we are using a club picture inside the flyer, so if say that picture doesn't have our club banner on the name of the club, and to recognize this is a club meeting, do we need to have those within the picture?
Yeah, you can always write it you can use text and write it there, right? You can mention your club meeting number, you can write the name of the name of your club. So on the picture also you can write. There is no such, on the picture you can have a object and then over the object you can write, or directly on the picture if the font is visible or evident, you can use it directly on the picture also. Even logo, now it is permitted. Now logo also, you can place it over the picture. But you need to make sure that it is distinct. It is separately visible. It is not getting lost inside the picture. So few points you need to just make sure whenever you are using a logo over the picture. So this is the minimum size which is there in the manual. So you can just go through it. So beyond that, it looks distorted. The Toastmasters International also, the trademark which is there, it will not be clear. So we need to stick to that minimum required size.
Okay, thank you so much.
You're welcome. Yes.
Can you share one of the posters of our club meeting?
Okay.
Ashwati, Anupama here from WBG Chennai Talk Stars Club. I just wanted to know if we have an option for motion flyer, a kind of an animated flyer in Canva. Do we have an option for that?
You're on mute, ma'am.
Yeah.
So sorry. You can always create like that. No, you have many options for animate the text. You can even animate the picture which you are placing on the flyer. So that way you can create an animate or motion flyer also.
But if I download a PNG version of that, when I present it in the email or something, will it be the same?
Not the PNG. You need to download as MP4.
MP4 only. Okay. Mm. Okay. Sure. Thank you.
There is a question regarding audio, ma'am. Audio yes. can be added in Canva.
Yes, in the same way, like how you do, how you upload a video, no, you just create a video, upload in the Canva. Same way, you can create an audio file or whatever file you are having. You can just upload on in Canva and just click drag and put. I'll show you. I will share the screen and show that part also. So this is something which we created. Now the audio, there are some free music also files which are available in Canva. You can go to the music, just click music. Yeah, so these are some free options which are available in Canva. So you can choose, just click and drag. Drag and drop. That's it. So that way you can add any kind of music. If you want to upload an audio file, again, you have to just record it, upload, and in audio, it will be there. So this is what you can...
ability to deconstruct the most critical challenges of life and offer holistic solutions and simple...
So this is something which I created. We made this audio and just uploaded here. And whenever you, wherever you need, you can just take it, drag and drop.
Swamiji is one of the most respected.
So this is how you can add music to the video.
I have one more question.
Yes.
For example, in a contest, the timer uses the timing device. So that can be used as a background for our, now I'm using this background. Are you able to see me? I don't know.
Yeah.
We can, thanks. So how do we upload that timer?
These timer cards are available in TMI website. You can just download it as your virtual background. You can download it and keep it as a virtual background. That's all. You need to just change it whenever you want to change according to the chime.
Okay, thanks a lot. I'm doing this VPPR role for the first time.
No problem. You can download all the three cards, four cards, in fact, even blue, green, yellow, and red. All these are available with the logo. You can just download it.
Not the timer background.
I'm talking
about the timing. That is, now, for example, we have a 3 minutes break between in the contest and all. Like that 3 minutes.
For that you can create a PPT also. So okay. In Canva there is an option when you select the template, you have presentation template also available. So you can just select presentation template, create your PPT, and then you can just share it. No, different slides will be there, like how you have a PowerPoint presentation, same way it will be, and you can save it as PowerPoint. When you save, there is an option in under downloads, you can save it as PowerPoint. So it will have slides, series of slides. So you can just change it while sharing.
Thanks a lot.
Yes. So I guess we are done for the day. So thank you so much. Thank you once again for joining and for such a wonderful, overwhelming response. And please stay tuned with our club and follow us and also join us in our future initiatives also. Thank you so much. Thank you all.
Thank you,
madam. Thank you so much.